So in the New Testament law, in the New Covenant under Jesus Christ, what would be the punishment for the murderer?
There has been forgiveness, brother.
The you mean they'll go scot-free?
The punishment.
Will they go? Will the murderers go scot-free?
God has forgiven them.
Answer the question.
If they are repentant.
So if somebody murders, wait a minute, let me ask you this.
Really repentant in the heart.
Yes.
God is forgiven.
Good. So if Hitler committed millions of murders, and if he truly feels in his heart that God forgive me, he'll be forgiven.
If he is truly repentant. Yes. Ask the most loving, the most forgiving God for forgiveness.
You know, I will never vote for you if you become a prime minister.
Why not?
Or a president.
Because
there won't be any jails here.
Of course there would.
There will be murderers and rapists running around. Okay, what happens to them?
Because I am not God.
No,
I do not know.
I didn't say you were.
In their hearts.
I'm asking you, from your Christian.
I'm concerned, from a point of human justice, I have to go under the assumption that they are not repentant.
No, I'm asking from the Christian.
That's why God is most
listen
loving.
To the question. Listen to the question.
Our justice
from the Christian perspective, how will you imagine? Imagine you were the king and you were going to be told to rule according to the New Testament. If you were the king, obviously in your kingdom there will be some black sheep who would be rapists and murderers. Yes? As a king, how will you establish law and order in your country without punishing any of these perpetrators?
I would.
How would you do it?
I am an imperfect man.
Yeah.
My justice system would be imperfect.
How would you do it? I'm asking.
How would I do it?
Yes. But make sure you deal with it based on the Bible. Because remember, the Bible is your code of conduct and law.
They have been forgiven for their sins.
Yes.
In terms of the afterlife.
Okay, good.
In terms of
carry
the
on.
Afterlife.
Carry on, yeah.
In this life,
yeah.
Due to the fact that I'm unable to know as a man if they are repentant in their hearts, my God does, right?
What will you do?
I will put them in jail.
So he will follow the Islamic law. Thank you very much. You see, this is the beauty of Islam. Because at the end of the day, wait.
No,
you see, you as a human being will only be able to follow the most just system, i.e. put them in jail. But you know what doesn't make sense to me?
What?
Is you as a Christian haven't been given this option to deal with the murderers and the rapists in this world. You haven't been given an option.
I'm telling you.
At least we got the Sharia, which tells us what to do. You guys go, forgive them. And you know what? This is not forgiveness. This is called payment by blood of an innocent. Do you understand the difference between forgiveness and payment? What is the difference?
Forgiveness is forgiveness without any payment. It's forgiveness for taking payment.
Okay, so in Christianity, is there forgiveness?
Only begotten Son.
I like the smile.
It's not a stupid.
It's a beautiful question because you see, you believe in forgiveness of God, yes, and you believe in the payment by God through His blood.
Atonement.
Through His blood.
Forgiveness.
Blood. The blood. It has to be the blood of an innocent, right? Now you tell me, you don't have the concept of forgiveness. The only concept they got is payment in blood.
Answer my question.
Yeah, go on. What is your question?
Man can forgive a murderer.
Based on what God said, yes.
Right, you can forgive him.
Yes.
Now, if that happens, when this murderer dies, is there any punishment for him or does he go straight to paradise?
There will be no punishment for him. Yes. Because he's still...
Wait.
But the thing is, you don't have any. Okay, you can walk away. That's fine. He thinks he won the argument. The thing is that in the Old Testament, when David murdered somebody, yes, there was no Jesus' blood that paid for his sin. He was forgiven for murdering someone that he lusted after the wife of. So he actually desired somebody's wife. I forget the name of the person. I mean, maybe somebody can remind me in the comments, perhaps. But that person was murdered by David. Guess what? He was forgiven. So if he's claiming that forgiving someone for murder is unjust, then he should deal with his own God. Because in the Old Testament, we have many such cases. If God wishes to forgive someone, then who are we to say otherwise? But the thing is this. When there is payment and no forgiveness, then that is a different thing. Because the payment by blood is not forgiveness, it is payment. He gave me the definition. The definition said, when you forgive someone means there is no payment. To me, that is mutually exclusive. Is it not? By his own definition. No wonder he ran away quickly, because that he realized at the end, because I saw a big smile on his face when I asked him, is there forgiveness in Christianity? And he said, like that, he smiled. Because that is when the penny dropped.